Hello everyone, myself Shruti Patkar from the Vidyalankar Institute of Technology. Today I and my group member Arif are going to cover the third module of ad hoc wireless sensor network, that is broadcasting, multicasting and geocasting in MANET. In this topic we are going to give you a rough idea about the broadcasting, multicasting and geocasting. So let's go through the topics that we are going to cover.
So here are the topics. First, I am going to explain the general definition of broadcasting, then a technical term of what broadcast is, then we are going to see a broadcast room and a protocol related to it, that is a simple flooding. This in a session on multicasting, its protocols, geocasting, its protocol, and in the end, we are going to summarize all. So here's the definition of broadcasting. It is a process in which one node sends a packet to all other nodes in the network.
Now let's understand the definition of a broadcast with the help of a diagram. So here I have one node which is a sender node and we have the other nodes in its vicinity. So what exactly a broadcast is? This sender node is going to send an information or it is going to send a packet to all other nodes in the vicinity. So this is the simple diagrammatical representation of a broadcast. Now this kind of transmission is one to all transmission, and since broadcast is one to all transmission, there is huge amount of traffic is generated which gives rise to a broadcast storm. Now let's understand what this broadcast storm is. We will consider node A and we will consider node B, C and D in the vicinity. Now, node A is a sender, it will send the information to all other nodes in the vicinity. Now, what happens as soon as the other node receives the packet, it will rebroadcast this particular packet to the neighboring node. For example, once the node B receives the packet from A, it will send an information to another node, something like this. The similar manner, node C and D will send the information. So a single packet is just going round and round in a network repeatedly, which gives rise to a broadcast storm. Now let's go ahead with the broadcasting protocols, which is simple flooding. But before understanding simple flooding, let us understand what exactly flooding is.
Flooding is the most simple method to broadcast the message. Now flooding can be explained with the help of a diagram over here. Let S be a node and S is the source node which sends the data to its neighbor node, that is node number 1, 5, 6 and 9. So once these neighbor receives the packet, it will forward this packet to their neighbors. So we can see the packet has been forwarded again and again and it causes the flooding. But a flooding increases redundancy of a packet, so it will waste a bandwidth.
As we have seen in the previous case that flooding increases redundancy. Now this redundancy can be minimized with the help of a technique which is simple flooding. Now let's understand with the help of a diagram what simple flooding is. So we will consider a sender which is A and we will consider its neighbors. Something like this. Now what happens is, the first step, the sender will send an information to all its one-hop neighbors, something like this. Now in the case of a simple flooding, what secondary nodes do, they only rebroadcast the packet once they receive the data from the sender. So these secondary nodes will rebroadcast its packet only once, and the same with these three nodes. So, compared to the previous case, we have seen in this particular case that all the nodes in the network are receiving the data. At the same time, the redundancy is very less. So, this is the advantage of simple flooding over a conventional flooding.
Multicasting. The definition of multicasting says it is a process of transmitting information to specific users among the all available users. It is used to efficiently transmit streaming media and other types of data to multiple users at the same time. Now here is a diagram of multicasting.
Now let's understand what multicasting is with the help of a diagram. Now we all know that multicasting is a transmission only to a specific users. So in this diagram, we will consider node A to be our sender, and here are different nodes in the vicinity. Now, since it is a transmission only to a specific user, node A will send an information only to the red nodes, not to the blue nodes. So this is nothing but a multicasting. In this particular type of transmission, this particular node may have its own network, so it might send a data to others. So we can say it is one to many or many to many communication. Now, what is the advantage of multicasting over a broadcasting? It is very simple that since the multicasting is not active all the time, so a bandwidth can be preserved, and at the same time the traffic can be very less compared to the broadcasting. Now let's move ahead with the multicast AODV, which is multicast ad hoc on demand distance vector protocol. Now this type of protocol is nothing but a reactive protocol, means in this case the route is discovered after the message is broadcast. Let us understand this multicast AODV with the help of this diagram. At the center we have a multicast source, and this particular two nodes, we can say they are the multicast receiver. So node, these three nodes are a part of a multicast route, and the blue nodes are nothing but the mobile host. Now a multicast source sends an information and it should reach to a multicast receiver. So how we are going to do it? It is very simple that a multicast source will send two types of commands. The one is RREQ, that is root request, and the other one is RREP, that is root reply. Now we can clearly see from the diagram that this particular multicast node is broadcasting RREQ, that is root request, to all its neighbor. But a root reply is coming from only those nodes which are nothing but a part of a multicast group. So for example, in this case, if some other mobile host wants to join this particular multicast group, it has to send a request first. Once a request is sent, all the members in a multicast group should acknowledge that request, and it will send the acknowledgement back to the particular node. Now let's move ahead with the multicast AODV, which is multicast ad hoc on demand distance vector protocol. Now this type of protocol is nothing but a reactive protocol, means in this case the route is discovered after the message is broadcast. Let us understand this multicast AODV with the help of this diagram. At the center we have a multicast source, and this particular two nodes, we can say they are the multicast receiver. So node, these three nodes are a part of a multicast group, and the blue nodes are nothing but the mobile host. Now a multicast source sends an information and it should reach to a multicast receiver. So how we are going to do it? It is very simple that a multicast source will send two types of commands. The one is RREQ, that is root request, and the other one is RREP, that is root reply. Now we can clearly see from the diagram that this particular multicast node is broadcasting RREQ, that is root request, to all its neighbor. But a root reply is coming from only those nodes which are nothing but a part of a multicast group. So for example, in this case, if some other mobile host wants to join this particular multicast group, it has to send a request first. Once a request is sent, all the members in a multicast group should acknowledge that request, and it will send the acknowledgement back to the particular node. Once a request is being accepted by all the multicast group, it has to send a pointer which gives the reverse route to that particular node. So this is how a multicast AODV protocol works.
Geocasting is? So here's a definition of geocasting. Geocasting is a technique of delivering data packets to a group of nodes located in a specified geographical area. So we can see.
Now let's understand the geocasting in a better way with the help of a diagram. As the definition of geocasting says, it's a process of sending an information to the group of nodes in a particular geographical area. So in this diagram, we will again consider a sender, which is A, and we will highlight these nodes, we will segregate them into a geographical area. So now, for example, these are nothing but the geographical zones. So a sender A will send the information to any of the geographical zones, something like this. So this particular area covers a geographical zone, and an information is only sent to the nodes which are there in that particular area. So depending on a mobility of the sensor, the sensor node may travel or they may shift the geographical area. So in this case, compared to the broadcasting and geocasting, the bandwidth is used moderately because the sensor nodes are not active all the time. They are on the sleep mode, but when there is a case of information exchange, the nodes turn into an active mode. So a bandwidth in this case is utilized moderately, and the traffic can vary since the nodes are mobile. Moving to a geocasting routing protocols, in this we are going to study LBM scheme 1, that is location based multicast scheme 1. This protocol is based on the forwarding zone. Now in this diagram we can see this huge rectangular box is nothing but a forwarding zone. So what is the concept of a forwarding zone? Let's understand. In this corner we have a sender, which is node A. A sender is going to broadcast a message to all its neighboring nodes. So a sender A will send an information to B, but node B can only receive the message if and only if node B lies in a forwarding zone. So for example, in this case, the message which is broadcast by A will be received by node B, but it won't be received by node C as it is outside the forwarding zone. Now, depend on this particular forwarding zone, the node B will further redirect that packet to all its neighbor which lies in their particular forwarding zone, and so that all the packets will reach to a particular required geographical region. So how does a forwarding zone is selected? So basically, forwarding zone is selected by considering two criteria. The first one is a location of a sender, and the second one a location of a geographical region. So based on these two criteria, we can send and redirect the packet so that it can be reached from the source to the destination. So this is all about the geocasting routing protocol LBM scheme 1.
Let's summarize all three with the help of a certain parameter. The first parameter is transmission. In broadcasting, it is one to all, since one sender sends the information to all the nodes in the network. In multicasting, it is one to many or many to many, since the sender can be a single or it can be a multiple. In geocasting, again, it is one to many, but a location or a geographical area based. The next parameter is processing time required. In broadcasting, more time is required since a sender needs to send data to all the nodes present in the network. In multicasting, the processing time required is less since the data is given to only the multicast members of the group. And in geocasting, the processing time required is moderate since we need to cover a particular geographic area. The next parameter is traffic. In broadcasting, unnecessary traffic is generated because the redundancy is more. In multicasting, redundancy itself is less, so traffic is less. And in geocasting, because an area is moderate, so a traffic is also moderate. The next parameter is management. In a broadcasting, no management is required as such, since data is sent to all the nodes of a network. In multicasting, management is required because a data needs to be sent to a multicast members group. And again, in geocasting, a management required because the data is stored to only nodes which lies in a particular geographic location. The next parameter is protocol. In broadcasting, we have studied simple protocol. Simple flooding. In multicasting, we have studied multicast AODV, that is ad hoc on demand distance vector protocol. And in geocasting, we have studied LBM scheme 1. So this is all about
the broadcasting, multicasting, and geocasting. Thank you so much for watching our videos.